In this video, guys, I'm gonna talk about 5 things I hate about my Scion XB. Now, mind you, it was really difficult for me to think of 5 things that I hate about the Scion XB because honestly, it's one of the best cars I've ever had. Very reliable, so it's hard to hate on that. All right, guys, number 1, in no particular order, is the size of the tires. The tires just aren't big. I know it's kind of an economical car. It is a small car, let me be honest. But even if you just compare these tires to the Honda Element, they're so much smaller. They're basically the size of Prius tires. Maybe they're a little bit bigger, but they're just not big tires. So anytime I'm going out on a rough road or a road with lots of rocks or a national forest road, which when you live in your car, sometimes you're out there. And let me tell you, I can't go fast at all. The tires are just too small. And that's kind of a minor complaint, guys. I'm gonna start off with the minor complaints and kind of work up to major complaints. So the second one we're gonna go right into it, guys, the seats. The seats are trash. Okay, mind you, I haven't shampooed them or cleaned them in a while, and I am a sweaty guy. I work all the time. I'm always sweating. I'm always sitting in here and editing and sweating. And so, long story short, the seats are just super uncomfortable and sticky. Sure, they got a lot of miles and a lot of sweat in them, but I just think the seats could be better. They're all right. Again, it was really hard to make this video, guys. There are a few ones that are coming up that are really gonna be like, okay, you know, I get why he's complaining about that. But yeah, the first couple complaints, like I said, it was hard to find complaints. Okay, the third complaint, which is still kind of in the category of hard to find a complaint, it's too low to the ground. There's hardly any clearance on this car. And, you know, it is a city kind of car. It's not really an off-road car. But still, come on, Toyota. At least, you know, lift it an inch off the ground. I mean, this thing scrapes over everything. My bumper's already pretty much scraped off. You know, every time I go over something, I'm pretty much scraping, and my suspension's pretty shot as well. So every time I go over a speed bump, my suspension pretty much bottoms out. It's not that bad, but it's damn close. You know, they could have just made it a little bit taller, but that ties into the size of the tires, guys. Small tires, not a lot of clearance. It's a disaster when you're going off road. I know a lot of you guys in the comments are like, well, Jeff, why didn't you just buy a Subaru? Jeff, why didn't you just buy a, you know, a truck? I don't want to buy a truck. I don't want a Subaru. So it is what it is. All right, guys, now let's get into some of the actual issues that I hate about this car. One of them is a very known issue, so it's not something that's just super rare for this car or my car in general these years, 2007, 2008. The Scion XB is oil burning overconsumption issue. So it burns oil, and I gotta put probably a quart every 2 weeks or 3 weeks in here. And so it's been an issue since I had the car. I went like a few months without knowing about it, unfortunately, guys. And I had to go into the oil change place and let them tell me that I had 2 quarts low in oil. And the only way I knew I was low on oil is the damn light had to come on my dash and say, hey, low on oil. And so originally I was a little scared and I was like, wow, this kind of sucks, man. But you get used to putting more oil in the car every month and it's honestly not a big deal. What am I, almost 40,000 miles on this car later? Not a big deal. It is annoying. You have to remember to do it. If your engine does get low in oil, it's definitely not good for it. But if it's a little low in oil, guys, it's actually normal for an engine to consume oil, especially over, you know, 150,000 miles. Excessive consumption is an issue though, and that's what I do have. But it is normal for engines to burn oil, but not as much as this car. They fix it in the upcoming years or the later years, but I don't really know. I don't really know what I'd have to do, guys, to get it fixed. I'd probably have to go get a whole new engine, basically. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna keep pouring oil in it, even though, you know, it's not really doing help for the environment, but I gotta do what I gotta do. I'd rather keep this car and just let it burn the oil then junk this car and go get a new car, you know what I mean? So yes, it burns oil. Yes, it sucks. That's probably the number one thing I hate about this car. Hate is a strong word though, so like I said, it was hard to make this video, guys, but I wanted to. Okay, the last but not least thing I hate about this car, which has been fixed and has been, we did what we needed to do, it's some sort of airflow sensor, I think. All you mechanics in the chat can tell me what it is, but I have an idle issue sometimes. It's hard to pinpoint when it happens, but it happens sometimes. It idles too low and I have to hit the gas to bring the idle back up and level it out. Sometimes it's when it's cold or I haven't started it in an hour or so. It'll do it, but other times I'll start it after a whole night and it'll be fine. Randomly, the idle will just go down and stop working. And it happens a lot when I'm in traffic. So like I'll go to a stoplight and I'll idle and it'll just drop too low. I'll have to turn on the AC or something. For some reason, when I turn on the AC, there it goes again, there it goes. See, I'll turn on the AC and it wants to idle low, but it'll bounce back. It just goes low for a second. And so that's another issue that's been going on. But again, guys, that's not really a big deal. Every car has its quirks. This car is definitely not an exception to the rule. And these are quirks that I've learned to live with. I've learned to just enjoy, I guess, in a certain way. But I mean, how do you enjoy it? These are things I've learned to live with the XB. It's not something I would totally say, hey, don't get an XB because it does this. I would say, yes, try to avoid 2007 and 8. Simply because the oil burning is expensive, it's annoying, it makes me want to just go get a Prius. But I'm not going to do that yet, guys. If I do that, then whatever. But I want you guys to know these are issues to look out for if you're going to get an XB. I don't hate this car, I love this car. I should make 5 things I would love about the XB next. So we'll see what's up. If you guys like this video, make sure you hit the like button, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. I highly recommend Toyota. Not sponsored. Hopefully you guys have a great day.